afternoon students. So today's procedure would be on IM injection, that is intramuscular injection. So in this procedure, I would be showing you how do you prepare the medicine and how do you prepare the patient for IM injection. So before we start preparing for IM injection, the first thing is that we go to the patient's bedside. We explain to the patient the procedure that would be done on the patient so as to relieve the discomfort of the patient, or if the patient is feeling scared or feared of taking the injection. So after that, we prepare the articles for IM injection. So the articles for IM injection are, you would be needing a knife dish where you'll be keeping the IM, the syringe. Apart from the syringe, you'll be needing the ampoule or the vial based on the medicine that is prescribed for the patient. So this preparation can also be done directly from the nurse station, or it can be carried and prepared near the patient bedside. Apart from it, you'll be needing a cotton swab, a spirit swab, then you'll be needing a kidney tray, and you'll be needing a paper bag to dispose of the waste cotton. So before we start the procedure, I wash my hand. After washing the hand, then you have to wear the sterile gloves. Now, when we talk about IM injection, it is injecting at the central muscles of a specific muscle site. So we give intramuscular injection mainly for patients who are contraindicated for other routes of giving injection, or for any specific injection that they get through IM injection. And the purpose of giving it is mainly for quick absorption and also for carrying out the required process specified process for the patient when they need to get it through IM. Then apart from it, you will also be the first thing is that when you prepare your patient, you have to prepare the first the thing is the medicine. So now the IM injection that we prepare is, we should have a medication chart. We should not forget it. That is, you'll be knowing what medicine you are giving to the patient, and to cross check with your patient which patient you have taken it, so that you don't make any medication error. So here I have already filled up the medication, that is the, I'm using it with the vial. So after I have drawn the medicine, I would be seeing for any fluid, like any air bubbles is it. So I have to see for the air bubbles, and if there is no more air bubbles, just a drop of the medicine is there, then I would be ready for providing the injection for the patient. So usually when we prepare for the patient, then we see for the, there are different sites for giving injection for the patient. We have first is the deltoid muscle. Now what is this deltoid muscle? It mainly starts from the acronym process of the scapula, and then it goes to the lateral aspect to the towards the humerus part. So here, this is the region. We'll be checking it, placing our four fingers here. We'll be seeing as a site, this is the region that we provide the injection for the intramuscular, that is the deltoid muscle. After we have provided the medication, slowly we put the medicine in the patient. Then after that, we removed it. Then we will be placing it with the spirit swab. This is one of the site that we do. Okay, then the next site that we do is, we have as the vastus lateralis. So this is just a procedure I'm showing you. So in the vastus lateralis, it will be on the anterior lateral aspect of the thighs, that is the upper thigh. So this will be one of the site that you will be providing the injection. So we can go it in the same way, that is by putting it our fingers out here, and then we rub first with the cotton swab out here, clean first the area, and then we provide the injection to the patient. How do we provide it? By putting our thumb and the index finger here, and the thumb we put it at the piston, and then we slowly release the medicine. But remember, before you release the medicine, you have to first withdraw it, whether to see it whether there is any blood coming out or not. If the blood is coming, you withdraw the medicine, but if the blood is not coming, then you can provide the injection. Then apart from this, the other side that you can provide for the patient is the V gluteal muscle. Okay, that is, we also call it as the ventrogluteal site. So when we place the patient for the ventrogluteal site, we mainly see for this area. Here I'm having a dummy.